The TRAI chairman there saying, looking at the option of combo vouchers. Let's go across now to Tech Mahindra. The management is speaking. The results, as we pointed out, better than street expectations.
Some of the initiatives we have taken will continue to come during the course of the year. I'm encouraged by the demand we are seeing for our offerings in managed services. Deal traction continues to be robust, and we are getting invited to large opportunities, essentially in Europe. We are seeing some signs of growth momentum in our non-BT business, and our sequential growth of 1.5% in constant currency. Our proposed merger with Mahindra Satyam, as you perhaps know, has met with overwhelming support from all the stakeholders. We look to progress this in an expeditious manner and leverage the benefits of a unified and larger base operations. As we approach the final phase of the process, we are focused on aligning the processes and systems across two companies. Coming to the financials, we had a fairly stable quarter with 1% constant currency growth. Revenue stood at INR 1,543 crores, up 19% year on year. In dollar terms, it was 281 million. EBITDA margin quarter one was at 21.4%, an improvement of 440 basis points quarter on quarter. EBITDA in absolute terms was at 330 crores, up 37% year on year, and in dollar terms, EBITDA touched $60 million, up 26% quarter on quarter. The profit after tax, including share of associates, was INR 338 crores, up 22%. In dollar terms, it was $61 million. As you would be aware, global economic situation continues to remain volatile and uncertain. The most immediate risk seems to be emanating from delayed or insufficient policy action. Given our business inherent dependent on the state of the global economy, we are not insulated from economic events. Customers are scrutinizing all aspects of expenditure, including IT spend, and looking at avenues to minimize financial commitments. Decision-making cycles in the telecom sector continue to be prolonged. And yet, if I may add, I'm not discouraged. I look forward to steady growth and steady earnings as we go forward. With these brief comments, I would like to hand over to Sanjay for his assessment of the current financial situation of the company and the economy as we go forward.
Thank you, Vineet. Good evening, everybody. We have had a good quarter with dollar revenues at $281 million, representing a 1% growth sequentially in constant currency terms, and industry-leading 440 basis points expansion in EBITDA. Our EBITDA at $60 million for the quarter and PAT at $61 million quarter, and revenue in INR terms at 1543 crores. EBITDA in INR was 330 crores and PAT at INR 338 crores. This improvement in EBITDA margin from 17% to 21.4% reflects the full benefit of INR depreciation and the benefits of our ongoing initiatives on operational optimization. Cash and cash equivalents stood at 280 crores. The steady reduction in our debt continues, with levels declining to 886 crores at quarter end as compared to 1127 crores at quarter four end. All other metrics for the quarter look stable. Our total headcount stood at 40,630, IT utilization and attrition stable at 74% and 19% respectively. We have seen most of our growth coming from the top 10 and top 5 customers. Our hedge book position at the end of the quarter was at $481 million at rupees 52.9 and £270 million at rupees 84. We continue to see good traction from Americas with a sequential growth of 5% and 7% year on year. Europe has degrown 2% sequentially but has a healthy pipeline as we look ahead. ROW continues to be a cyclical business and has grown 8% year on year, but it's down 4% sequentially. We continue to enhance our focus on profitability improvement through further measures on operational excellence. I would now open the floor to questions.
Well, that's the management of Tech Mahindra. The numbers, as we pointed out, ahead of street expectations. More numbers today. Onto the earnings space from Rand Baxter.